Hi everyone, and welcome to episode 22 of the Evently Live Chat Show. Today we're going to have an interesting interview with Marcel. Marcel is the owner of Gozo Go Active and Game Hut, which are both based in Gozo. He is Dutch, living here in Walta and Gozo, so I'm excited as well to see why he chose to come here, even his business and everything. And there's also some interesting things that I'd like to go over, and I hope you guys do enjoy this topic with regards to a different type of event that they've started organizing, of course, due to COVID, which is online team building activities for companies. As always, I'd like to thank everyone for watching the shows. I'm very, very happy with the amount of viewers we're having, all your questions, feedback. And please, if you have any questions or have any feedback, you've worked with Marcel before, whatever, let us know while we are live. In the meantime, I am inviting Marcel in. Hello.
Hi, hello.
Hi, Marcel. How are you?
Yes, I'm fine.
Super, super. How's the weather in Gozo?
The weather is great. So, very super. Enjoyable.
We've got sunshine everywhere.
Yes.
Super, super. So first off, thank you very much for accepting the invitation to be on our show today. The topic of the online team building activities is, I think, a first on this show for our viewers, as well as even all the other activities that you do organize. So I do want our viewers to understand, and we'll be going through all the different activities and services that you offer. But first, perhaps you could introduce yourself a bit for today's audience.
Yes, okay, Alberta. I am Marcel, and I am born in the Netherlands, like you said. And I have been in leisure industry for almost 20 years now.
Okay.
Yes. And 2 years ago, me and my family decided to move to Gozo.
Interesting, interesting. Is there a particular reason why you chose the Maltese Islands?
Yeah, actually there is. We looked all over Europe for a nice small country with a good climate and where they speak English and have nice people. But then it only goes so.
I hope we fit the expectation then for you. And is there a particular reason why you chose Gozo instead of Malta, or?
Yes, actually, I like Gozo because it's more quiet, more rural, more green, actually. So like it pretty much. Malta is a little bit too busy for me to live. So we work in Malta also, but for living and to be based as a company, we choose Gozo.
Super. I actually do have a few friends that do live in Gozo, and they prefer it with a hard week just because it's much more relaxed. And here it's so busy, you have traffic on Saturdays, you know, you just want to enjoy a day off and all this. And you guys have it all there. thank you for giving us a bit of an introduction. When you mentioned you have 20 years of experience, so before you moved to Malta, you were still doing these types of activities, or did you venture in different, did you learn different experiences over your path?
Yes, we have done also other things, like we still have a holiday resort in Poland. And we started to do leisure activities like the treasure hunt, but also like paintball over there. And we do a lot of team building activities over there, also like bachelor parties, hen parties. So
cool. Okay.
Almost 20 years already over there. And now we're just doing it also over here, except the paintball.
Okay. All right, okay.
We would love to, but we have to figure out how to do it over here.
Step by step. I mean, you've only been 2 years now here in Malta, correct?
Yes.
Sorry, Gozo. Sorry. Well, the Maltese.
Yeah. Part of Malta.
Exactly. So let's dive right into the services that you offer now. And I have split it in two parts for our viewers to be able to understand. I know you have Gozo Go Active, and then you have the Escape Room Game Hut.
Yes. Right.
So what are the services that you offer under Gozo Go Active?
Okay, so in Gozo Go Active, we do laser games. So that's basically a recreational shooting sport where the participants use an infrared light gun, and they can shoot at each other's guns or other targets. So it's basically a team sport. That's what we offer at Gozo Go Active. And we also do archery, for example, and of course the treasure hunts.
Amazing. Okay. Are there any particular activities that seem to really hit it off well, like for fun events with family and friends, or for like companies when they're doing team building activities?
It's actually fun for all the things you mentioned. So it's good for families and friends, but also great for team building experiences for companies. Yeah,
I love the laser tag option as a team building activity. Get it out there, you know.
Yeah.
Go in, have fun, kill each other, and then come back.
Kill each other. Well, but it's a real team sport, of course. So you go team against team, and it will get your adrenaline running.
It's very good as well. I mean, building that challenge as a team, and everyone has to try and find ways to work well together effectively, but in a fun environment. So I'm pretty sure it's sought after.
Yeah, it's not only shooting. So it's think of tactics as a team. How can you conquer the other team, actually?
Yeah. Amazing. Okay. So that covers a bit with Gozo Go Active. Now, with Game Hut, can you explain a bit the different services?
Yeah. So Gozo, the Game Hut, we opened up the beginning of this year an escape room on our venue in Victoria. But we expanded it with other portable escape games, actually. So to explain what is an escape room, you get kind of locked up in a room and then you have 60 minutes to escape the room. You do that as a team with like, for example, four or maximum of eight people. You solve puzzles, you find codes, you open padlocks, and then finally you will find the exit to go out.
Amazing. Okay. And do a lot of people manage to do it in the 60 minutes?
I think like 40%.
Wow. Okay. So this is a real challenge.
Challenge. Yes.
Interesting. I really like it.
Well, the fun thing is that to do it as a group, one can calculate very good, the other knows how to solve puzzles, so it's real team effort also.
Interesting. Interesting. And I don't know if you can explain a bit for our viewers as well, which quantities of people, like can any amount of people team up for an escape room event?
In the escape room, for every 60 minutes, we can do only one group, especially at the moment, and there's a maximum of eight participants.
Okay. Okay. And with the other events, such as the laser tag, the archery?
Yeah, so normally with laser tag, we can do up to 24 people at the same time, but of course, now it is limited.
Of course. And we will get into this. I have dedicated a specific question for our viewers so you guys can understand the measures that Marcel has taken up to be sure that you guys can still do your activities, but in a safer environment. Thank you, Marcel, for answering my questions. With quantities, I think I wanted to ask it mainly because let's say you have, I don't know, a company that they're trying or a group of friends, there are 30 people and they want to do this. Would you have them sort of having maybe some food and a drink while the others are doing it? So do you split it out or?
Yes, exactly. That's a possibility. Okay. Yeah, we have capabilities. And we have several games. So, for example, one group can do another thing in one place and then change. So Now, if you have like 10 people together, one can do, for example, archery in one place and do an escape game in another place.
Okay. All right. Okay. Very fun. Interesting.
And then they can change later.
Exactly. Exactly. So you can get even different challenges put together so everyone's enjoying the whole day.
Yes. Yes.
Super, super. Going on to my next question for you, Marcel, I did want to ask the typical customer that you normally have coming to you. Is it tourists? Is it mainly the corporate industry?
At the moment, it's not a lot of tourists. we have some. But basically it's great for tourists, but also for like team building activities for businesses, but also for groups of friends and families. We do a lot of birthdays, for example.
Okay.
Or bachelor's parties.
All right. Okay. Yeah. And I have another question. Is there a particular age limit? So like they can't be younger than, I don't know what age for particular... Like they can't be under three, I guess, you know, sort of.
Yeah, of course. So for escape games and escape rooms, we advise that the minimum age is like 8.
Okay.
And so we wouldn't advise to send children without any adults. So it's more like, okay, you can do it for some children and you can do it with adults together, so like the parents, for example. That's better because otherwise some puzzles will be too difficult.
We are
actually building a pirate themed escape game.
Okay.
More suited for smaller children.
Cool. Okay.
We have a lot of requests actually for smaller children also.
Okay.
I think it would be nice to do it for smaller children also with some more simple puzzles.
Definitely. And I do also want to let our viewers know, so earlier this morning we did put a post in preparation for today's show and you gave me some really cool photos. There was a photo of with the lasers coming down and there was like a person that had to go around with the green lights. There was another photo, I'm guessing, with the red light of the one of the escape rooms.
Yes, right? Yes. That's true.
And then there's one photo where there's actually kids doing a shooting event, like playing between them doing this event, which was really, really cool. Because I always thought it was maybe for an older age group, but they looked quite young. They looked maybe 8, 9 years old.
Yeah, we have a lot of birthday parties. Not at the moment, but we did last year a lot of birthday parties.
All right.
Yes.
Okay. Are there any of the activities that you offer that are most popular, say like with team buildings? It's like a lot of people seem to go for these type of events, and then with kids parties or kids events they go with these, or even get togethers with friends and family.
For kids events, the laser game is most popular, but at the moment we have a big interest in the mobile escape games.
Okay.
And also on the online escape games.
Okay. I wanted to explain a bit more of the mobile and the online escape games, but I don't know if you're going to put it for me in the question when I'm asking you about online.
Okay, I can do that.
All right.
Now or later.
however you want. Because I did focus the question on online team building. So if this is different, then go for it. Explain it for us.
Okay, so for a mobile escape game, I can show you the camera. So this is, for example, escape box.
Okay.
So it's a suitcase. So when it's closed, then you have to open it as a group, and then you have to solve all kinds of puzzles, open locks, open boxes, and find other items. And then you have a timer on it. It is also 60 minutes. So you have actually 60 minutes in this particular game. It's called Korean Threat. So you have to put the timer off before the 60 minutes expire. So it's really fun. That's one item. We can do this actually because it's a suitcase. We can do that almost everywhere. So we have done it in bed and breakfast, in hotels, but also when people want to have a party at their house and do something unusual. Yeah, they do it. They do these games.
Ah, cool. Okay. I don't know if there are some fun experiences that you've gone through in the 2 years you've been working with the Maltese, or at least on the Maltese islands. Like any particular events that really stood out for you?
Mostly, I like when the children do this laser game. For example, they really enjoy themselves. That's real fun to see actually in that day, because in Gozo was a lot of complaints. Oh, there's nothing to do. And when I arrived, I thought, okay, let's do something, especially for the children. So that's my experience.
Cool. All right. Okay. I was also going to ask you actually, because you mentioned it's a Korean, the box is a Korean.
Yeah, this box is called Korean Thread.
Korean Thread. How do you come up with these ideas? Is there a back end brainstorming person that comes with everything for you?
Basically, they did it for me, so I didn't come up with it myself. So basically, they write a story about something, about an event, what can happen. Like in this case, the threat of the Korean leader, he will have an explosion. So it's also there's also some film we will show a few minutes before they start to play, to explain what this is about.
Yeah.
And these kind of puzzles, you have the locks, you have the padlocks, you have puzzles, so you have to think of all these things.
And,
To, to figure it out, but it's nice to do, actually.
Exactly. It's a very, for me, I've never heard something like it, and I'm sure you have many other different, names of cool different, escape rooms with different names or, these boxes. Like, you have this box, Crane, you have other stories to tell.
So we'll have, for example, a mafia box. So
yeah.
This will have more of a mafia kind of puzzles. And in the escape room in our venue in Victoria, we have at the moment only one room. We will expand, but we have at the moment one room. It's called the Templar's Castle.
Okay,
you have a citadel in Gozo, so with the Templar's Knights, the history of Malta. We thought, okay, let's do something with that.
Super interesting. I love the ideas, and I also love that you said your whole team even works together to brainstorm and come with the different ideas. So you, even when your whole team is working, there are different aspects that they're working on. It's not just meeting with the people and doing the activity on the day, right? I mean, they're going from the back end, preparing and everything to then.
Yes, exactly. So, for example, for the treasure hunts, we have some treasure hunts set out, but we can also make them especially for a company if they want to have some items in it. So we can make tailor-made hunts also.
Super.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you for answering all of my questions, Marcel. I did mention I like to come in with different questions because sometimes certain things just pop in. Like, I'm sure people are interested in knowing sort of what age group, that they can do an event like this if they have children, for example.
Uh-huh.
Now, my next set of questions is related with the whole situation that we've been going through for 2020. Every business has been affected in some way or another. I'm sure because you are a very physical business, you have been affected. And I know that you've taken certain measures right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
To always offer that safety first. What are the measures that you've put in place?
Yeah, so we fully comply actually with the government restrictions there are at the moment. So we limit the group, the amount of people who can do together. We do only one group at a time, so not to mix any groups of any people. We use the face masks, the sanitizers. We clean everything thoroughly in between groups, so everything will be safe. Where it is possible, we use the social distance. And yeah, that's basically what we do at the moment. And furthermore, we purchased online games, especially. So actually, there is no physical appearance, so people can play from their home or from their work spot. So that's something we did also. Yeah.
Cool. So like, I wanted mainly to ask this question with the measures, because I know a lot of people sort of, even for example, when you're going to eat at a restaurant, you want to know that the restaurant or anywhere that you're going is actually complying to the measures that are set out. You're not, you know, in a small space, cramped up with another person, mm-hmm, and all course. These things. So I wanted these points to come out for you, especially because you have the escape room and even the activities are still quite physical, the other activities yes. you have. Mm-hmm. Again, my next question is with regards to COVID-19. Have you still been able to create fun and safe group activities for your clients in a physical way?
Yes. So what we basically do in our venue is to let one group in at once. And normally we can do one group after the other, but now we keep an hour in between so we can clean and we close the door so yeah. nothing can come in. Yeah, the door of the room will be closed anyway, but I mean the door of the shop is closed also, so nobody can actually go in.
All right.
But that's okay. And we limit the group, of course, so.
Of course. So the reason that you're doing eight at a time, you said, right?
Yes.
Okay. So the main reason is with regards to COVID, not because yeah. the room takes up eight to eight.
No, we have because you need one or two operators, so then it's already 10.
Okay. All right. Okay. So there is still a person in there.
No, not in the room, but outside. Okay. But we thought it is better to limit it, like including the operator, even if he is in another room. But
yes.
Same building. So we thought it's better to do it like that to not get confusion.
And do the people know that there is the operator there? Like, do they try asking him questions?
Yes, they do. So we have like a monitor in the room. Which on the monitor is the time, which counts down from 60 minutes to zero. And then we provide hints on screen, but we also have an intercom so they can press the bell and ask questions if they need any help.
Okay, so they are allowed to ask questions. I would be like, yeah. No, you have to do it on your own.
That's why we have 40% maybe of the success.
It's very good, though, that they are still quite hard, because I guess, do the people come back again when they see that they've only managed, they haven't managed, do they come again to try it again?
No, because after, if they don't succeed, we will explain after the game how it works. So, because it's nice to know, and then they say, oh, yeah, it's like that. So.
Yeah. So even if people, guys, you don't manage, you're still going to be told, basically. So it's nice to know the final execution, so you know exactly where you went wrong and improve and so on. Super. I do want to go into the question that I have next for you with regards to the online team building activities. This is a very interesting question, so I do want to take a bit of time here to fully explain how and what this service is.
Okay, so we have two kind of games which can be played online. So for one, we will send a box to each participant, to their home or to their working spot. It's used only once, but it has some items. And then with a video call within the system, so that all the members come together, and one will solve this puzzle, the other will solve this. So it is a team effort to reach a goal, actually also to escape the firm, it is called. So it is completely safe and the same fun actually as an escape room. We also have a hacking game that is without without a package, so without any items which will be sent. So the hacking game, it's for there needs to be a basic knowledge of computers.
Okay.
To play actually, but then actually you hack a system together, so you are not within the system with, so not with the conference call like the other game. But within the system, you also work together. You can chat together. You can have fun together. But the goal is to actually escape, also to beat the system, to hack.
This is very interesting. Yeah. Okay. And is there like a minimum or a maximum amount of people that can be involved in the online?
Wait, these games, no.
Super. Okay, all right. As well, I wanted to ask if you have any sections on your website or perhaps on your Facebook pages that people can find the information in full for these online activities.
Yes, yeah, so we have for the online activities, we just started with it. So we didn't put it online. We will put it online pretty soon because we just had the materials. And so basically on our website, everything is available, but for the online activities, we need to put it on.
Super. Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. Again, now I'm going to explain a bit with regards to where people can find you. So I already have the links in front of me, at least for your Facebook pages. So if you just go to Facebook and you go search Gozo Go Active, one word, you'll find the profile page for the first company. And then if you do Escape Room Game Hut, you're going to find for the second company, which is with the Escape Room. I don't know as well if you want to give the link to your website and how people can reach or contact you, Marcel, for this.
Okay. Yeah, that's no problem. I would like to do that, but I don't know how.
The website is www.
Yeah, so the one is gozogoactive.com.
Okay. All right. It's just the one. Or do you have another one for the Game Hut?
Yeah, we have gamehut.eu.
Super.
Yeah, so and people can book online, or our telephone number is on it, so they can book by phone.
Okay. So they can go to the site, choose the activities they want, and just go for booking online.
Exactly, yes.
Very easy, very convenient. Yeah, yeah. And you do it any day and any time, or there are set days and times they can do particular events?
Any day, any time.
Amazing.
Mixture, provided there is availability at the moment.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. We're going down to our last three questions, Marcel. So my question, which I do believe you slightly answered before for us, is if the activities you organize are just in Gozo or if you're flexible with the locations?
No, we can do it actually everywhere, most of them. Of course, not Escape Room, but other escape games as well, Treasure Hunt, as well as Laser Game, we can also do in Malta. And also all the escape games, like online, of course, it can be done everywhere. But also the box we can take to Malta, for example.
Interesting. Okay, very good to know. My next question for you is, we're going down to an end now. So I think we have covered everything, I hope, with regards to Gozo Go Active and Game Hut, Marcel. Mm-hmm. Correct me if I'm wrong. Mm-hmm. I try to be as detailed as possible, especially for you, the viewers, so that you can understand every different type of service that Marcel is offering together with his team. I especially wanted you guys to know as well, it's not just based in Gozo, apart from the escape room, that is, I mean, a fixed thing, you know, you can't exactly transport the room, but that's something interesting. Marcel, perhaps having like a huge bus transitioning into an escape room, and you can have it done anywhere or everywhere.
How did you know we had that idea? Oh, but that's a possibility. Yes, yes.
It is.
We're thinking about that. Yeah.
Amazing. Cool. All right. Because I thought you're able to offer all your services then across anywhere on the island.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I'm guessing even for you, it's a bit fun to get to be moving around with everything as well.
Absolutely. Yes.
Super. My question before the last for you today is if you have any advice for people watching the show, your clients, our audience today.
Okay. I should say stay safe, but try to have some fun also in this difficult period. And there is safe ways to have fun actually.
Definitely. It is the main priority, especially with the last week, how numbers have been
increased.
Changing. It's quite a bit.
Yeah.
But yes, I think stay safe and still have fun is very important. We still need to get a bit of fresh air and go out. We still need to be social, speak. So I do think this online activity system that you've done is super, super good, because at least people, if you're stuck at home alone and, you know, perhaps your work is telling you to work from home, realistically, it might be boring. I mean, you're in the same house day after day. So I think it's extremely good advice, Marcel. Thank you very much. My last question for you and the team is, what are your future plans for you personally and your family and even for the businesses that you're operating in Malta and Poland?
Mm-hmm. Okay. For our future, actually, we're going to move to another spot in Gozo. From Arp, we are now in Arp. We live in Arp and we go and move to Alla. So I have to, some packing to do.
That's exciting.
It's exciting.
You can say exciting or stressful. We can say different ways.
So, and for the business, we will open up. We are preparing the second room in our venue, so it will be nice for people if they have done one, they can do another one. And we are planning to do some more rooms, but we actually are building the second room now. As I told you, we are busy with the Pirate Team portable escape room for the children. We are also studying about virtual reality, which is also a great game, also with games, but actually also for escape rooms. And so we are pretty busy looking for more possibilities.
That's very good to hear. You're keeping up, you know, you're moving, coming up with different ideas and continuing expanding. So that's very great to hear. I've covered all my questions for you, Marcel, today. Thank you very, very much for taking the time to do this interview with me. For all our viewers to know, this video is shared on all the different Facebook pages, the two of Marcel's and ours of Evently. The video will also be on Marcel's profile page on Evently, which is in the link in the post description. And I will say it for you. It's evently.com.mt/profile/GozoGoActive. I don't know if you have any final words before we end the show, Marcel.
I just want to thank you for this opportunity, Alberta. I really enjoyed the thing we did, the talk we had. And wish you good luck.
Super. Thank you very much. I wish you good luck as well. Do keep in touch. Let us know as well when you do the second escape room. Perhaps you can do a quick video for people to go in and have a look.
Good idea.
Super. I'm going to wave you goodbye, Marcel. Okay. So thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. There you have it, guys. Marcel, I would like to pronounce his surname, but if you need his surname, it's in the post description as well for you guys. This was a very interesting interview for me today, because I did want to push with fun events for families, for people. You know, you want to get together with your friends, but you don't want to go perhaps in crowded spaces, or you don't want to go to a particular bars or anything of the sort. You're able to build activities like this. And even if you're working in the team, you know, you want to have fun. We've been all so stressed out this year. So doing team building activities for the team is very good. You know, you want to put up the morale. You want to get everyone a bit laughing a bit and just enjoying what is left of 2020. hoping that we're going to have an amazing 2021. Guys, thank you very much for watching the show, and I see you guys next time. Bye-bye.